Lord, dear students, today we will read the first chapter of Indian history, that is Brick, Beads and Bones, the Harappan civilization, that is also known as River Valley civilization. Its time period is 3500 to 1200 before Common Era. This civilization is divided into three phases. That is the early phase of the civilization. The early phase of civilization, its time period is 35 to 2600 before Common Era. This is considered early phase of Harappan Valley civilization. The next one, the mature phase of civilization, that is 26 to 1900 before Common Era. And the next one, that is the latter phase of civilization. Its time period, that is 1900 to 1200 before Common Era. So we may divide the civilization into three phases. That is the early, when the people, they settled down there. The next one, which we called the most developed period of this civilization, knows 2600 before Common Era to 1900 before Common Era. And the next one, the latter phase, during that time period, that civilization declined. This civilization is also known as River Valley civilization. Why that is civilization is known as River Valley civilization? Let me write down some centers of civilization. You automatically will understand why this civilization is known as River Valley civilization. Let's see one by one. It's Harappa. It is located on the bank of River Ravi. Mohenjo-daro. It is on the bank of Indus River. Kot Dizi. It is on the bank of Indus River. Chanhu-daro. It is also on the bank of River Indus. Rakhigadi. That is on the bank of Saraswati River, located in Haryana. Then Banwali. It is also on the bank of Saraswati River. Lothal, on the bank of Sabarmati River, then Dholavira, it is on the bank of Luni River, Nageshwar, it is on the bank of Narmada River. Kalibanga, it is on the bank of Ghagga River. This is the reason you just see all the major center of this civilization, they are located on the bank of a particular river. This is the reason this civilization is known as River Valley Civilization. But when you study the chapter, it indicates Harappa Civilization. Now the things comes, why this is known as Harappa Civilization, or somewhere that is written Indus Valley Civilization. The reasons that is very clear, because Harappa, it was the first city that was excavated in 1921 by Mr. Dayaram Sahani, Mr. D.R. Sahani. This is the reason this civilization was known as Harappa Valley Civilization. On the other hand, you also study, that is Indus Valley Civilization. You just have reached some major centers like Mohenjo-daro, Chanhu-daro, Kotdizi. These centers were very important. Among them, the most important is Mohenjo-daro. It is considered that Mohenjo-daro was the center of administration. This is the reason it was known as Indus Valley Civilization. Mohenjo-daro, because that was known as the administrative center, it was located on the bank of Indus River, excavated in 1922 by R.D. Banerjee, Rakhal Das Banerjee. That's about that, why this civilization is known as Indus Valley Civilization or Harappa Valley Civilization or River Valley Civilization. Now let's come on another topic, that is subsistence strategies of Harappan people. That is subsistence strategies of the peoples. Mean to say, how the Harappan peoples, they get their livelihood, how they got the food. It is discovered or excavated by archaeobotanists that Harappan peoples, they were well versed in some grain. These people, they had knowledge of some food grain like wheat, barley, lentil, sesame, and millets. They were well versed.
they were well versed about these food grains. These peoples were well versed about these food grains. Then archaeologists. These peoples excavated that the peoples, those who were residing in Harappan Valley civilization, they domesticate the animal. They domesticate sheep, goat, buffalo, and others. These people also ate meat because these peoples got bones of some animals near these settlements. They got bones of deer, wild boar, ghadiyal, and others. But it is still not clear whether these animals were hunted by them or by others. That is about their excavation done by these peoples. Now let us study about the agriculture technology of the Harappan peoples. That is agriculture technology. Agriculture technology that was used by the Harappan peoples, we got a terracotta plow model, a Cholistan Banavli. That is a model of ox and plow. It suggests that the peoples, those who were residing there, they do cultivation with the help of plow. Then second, we got the evidence of plug filled eight Kali Bangal. Kali Bangal, as it itself suggests, the area where the black bangles were found and the black soil is there. There we got the evidences of plug filled. Another thing, we got evidences that Harappan people, they do two crops simultaneously. Two crops were grown by them, and then we got evidences of irrigation, that the peoples of Harappa, they use irrigation method to do the cultivation. These peoples were well versed in canal. We got the evidences at Shurtgai. Shurtgai, that is there in Afghanistan. There, the evidences of canal have been found. Secondly, lot of well have been found. That suggests the people, they do cultivation by getting the water from the well. Then, it is water reservoirs. Dholavira. From Dholavira, we got evidence these people, they do cultivation with the help of the water that they store. And the next one is, the important one is the monsoon, rain. Their cultivation that is was done with the help of these four methods. Now that we have studied here, subsistence strategies, we have studied the agriculture technologies. Dear students, we have studied Mohenjo-daro. I have talked Mohenjo-daro.
Now let's read about this center. It is very important place that is known Mohenjo-daro and plant urban settlement. What we call it? A plant urban center.
That is the most important center that is discovered, that is excavated by Rakhal Das Banerjee in 1922. That is spread 125 acres of land. It is the largest settlement that we discovered till date. We think so. The Harappan administration that was done from Mohenjo-daro. Let's read about its plant urban centers. Mohenjo-daro that was divided into two parts. One that is upper town. Second that is lower town. One that is upper town. Second that is lower town. Upper town that is smaller, but higher. See what I am saying? Smaller. It shows what I am saying, that only a few people were residing there. That was on high part. That's height was up. Second one, lower, larger, but lower, larger, but lower. It suggests that lot of buildings were there, lot of people they were residing there, but it is on the lower part of the city. It itself suggests, if we compare these two, it suggests in the upper town, the nobles they were residing, the rich people they were residing, the administrators were residing there. On the other hand, lower town, it is where the common people they were residing there. But what special features we got? It is lower town as well as upper town. They were constructed on a, the houses they were constructed on a platform. That is brick mud platforms. Another special feature of both the towns, they were covered by wall. Like that, I did so. It is surrounded by a wall. It itself, I do. Covered by wall. Both the settlements. It means they were physically separated by the wall. That is Mohenjo-daro. Now let's continue the plant structure of Mohenjo-daro. But the special features of Mohenjo-daro was here, that is laying out drains. Laying out drains, It means Mohenjo-daro that was plant, the roads, the streets, they were first plant, the sewerage system was plant, later on the houses, the buildings that was constructed. It suggests that drainage system was well planned by them. The street, they were planned first. The roads, they were planned first. And what the special features of the roads were there? They intersect to each other. Then the houses, they were constructed. Another features of houses were there. Each and every house, they had a bathroom. And that is connected with drainage system. Mean to say, the all the waste water of the house that drains through the drainage system. Now the next is, that is domestic architecture. Domestic architecture, mean to say how their house they were constructed. As I have told you just now, first the roads they were constructed, then it is houses they were constructed. That domestic the features, the special features of domestic character, special features of domestic. Special features of domestic architectures were there, that the houses, they had courtyard. Courtyard, they had one inner portion. They were very much conscious about their privacy. They don't have windows on the wall. Third thing, these people, they had bathroom in their houses that is connected by the drainage system. Next one, the from outside, the inner part of the house couldn't visible. That was the special features of domestic architecture. Then the next one, some houses they had staircase. Staircase to reach to second story. Some houses they had second story, and for that purpose there was staircase. And to reach the roof of the houses they had staircase. Then we will read citadel. The citadel. That is located in the upper part, upper town. Upper town, one special feature that is there known as citadel. What we call that is citadel. Citadel that is there on upper town. What the special features of citadel? Two great buildings were there in citadel. One that is warehouse, second great bath. I have mentioned two special buildings, they are located in Citadel. One warehouse. Let me give a very simple example today. Dear students, nowadays we are suffering by a disease, corona, and we are residing our house, no production activity is done. See, during that time also these people, they suffer, they face problem. For that purpose, In that warehouse, they keep the food grains so that it will come when they required, whenever they need. They will use the food grains that is kept in warehouse that might be used for their purposes. Another very important picture was there, great bath. Great bath, it is very important building. I'll tell you the features of great bath that was there during that time period. Let me try to make, with the help of a drawing, great bath, because some rituals were performed for that purpose. The great bath was constructed. Let me write down the measurement of great bath. Great bath, that is, its length was 180 meter. Its width, that is 108 feet. That is the area of great bath. That's the length, that's the width, that is the total area in which the great bath had been constructed. The size of great bath is 39 feet long, 23 feet width, and it was 8 feet deep. That is 8 feet, and it had plants, mean to say staircase, to reach the great bath on two sides. These were the staircase. Through that they reach there. Another thing, it has some rooms on three sides. That's it, the some building that was there. One room, two room, three, one, two, three, four. The four bathrooms, they are this side. Four bathrooms, they are this side. That is the special features. On one side, in a room, they are having well. On the other hand, this side, they had drainage system. The wastewater, that is drainage through that one. That is the special features of great bath. Now, the thing is there for which purpose that was used. Great bath, we have some rituals, some special days. During that time periods, it was considered very auspicious to take bath. Let me give you some examples of present scenario. Your grandfather might have say sometimes that they will go for Ganga Sanan. It is a Purnima day is there, it's a Amavasya day is there, or Yamuna. The similar, it was the great bath, it had the purpose of great taking bath. These were considered as special rituals. So for today, it's okay. Good day. Stay home. Stay safe. Good day, dear students.